Is it possible to reduce inflammation by changing our diet? The answer is yes. There are many scientific studies showing that certain foods cause inflammation while others reduce inflammation. Some people have chronic inflammatory diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, ankylosing spondylitis, ulcerative colitis, and they report improvements in their symptoms when changing their eating habits. Today, I'll answer some questions. What is the anti-inflammatory diet? Is it healthy? For how long do I have to try until I see the benefits? So let's talk about anti-inflammatory diet today. First, I need to explain what inflammation is, so you understand why the anti-inflammatory diet is so important. And maybe that will help you to adhere to this diet for the rest of your life, not only for a few months. Inflammation is a normal reaction of the body to any threat, insult, trauma, attack, or infection. Your immune system reacts by sending white blood cells to combat the insult, for example, to kill the bacteria or eliminate the cancer cells. However, in autoimmune diseases, there will be a chronic inflammation that is not normal. Autoimmune diseases occur when your immune system recognizes your own cells has something that is threatening, and then it will start attacking the normal cells. This is what happens in rheumatoid arthritis, psoriasis, ankylosing spondylitis, inflammatory bowel diseases, some types of thyroiditis, diabetes type 1, multiple sclerosis, and many other diseases. We don't know if fibromyalgia, which is a chronic pain condition, is also an autoimmune disease or not. There are some recent indications that people with fibromyalgia have chronic inflammation going on because there are inflammatory markers that are higher in people with fibromyalgia. Now, if you are overweight, pay attention to this. Fat tissues release pro-inflammatory molecules like leptin and cytokines. So when you adhere to an anti-inflammatory diet, the inflammation may not go down just because this fat tissue is releasing those pro-inflammatory substances in the fat tissue around you. Now, please remember that this video is only for educational purposes only. And if you have a condition that needs medical advice, please talk to your doctor. And if there is an emergency, go to the nearest emergency department. I usually do not recommend my patients to do a radical diet for a few months and after that they can come back to their regular diet. I think that doesn't work. My approach is to incorporate healthy eating habits in your life for good. If this diet is overwhelming to you, try changing one thing at a time. It is better to go slow and stick to it than to abandon it because you could not persevere. So, what is an anti-inflammatory diet? I'm sure you will not be surprised by it, as there are a lot of common sense in this diet. And if you know someone who needs to see this video, press the share button below and send to them. Number one, avoid white bread, white flour, and gluten, and replace by gluten-free flour like almond flour, oat flour, brown rice, corn flour, tapioca, or cassava flour. Number two, avoid white sugars, any kind of sugar or artificial sweeteners, and replace by homemade sugar-free jams or just plain fruit that already contains sugars. It takes time to retrain your taste buds to sense natural sugars in fruits, vegetables, or milk. But once you train your taste buds without any added sugar or sweetener, you'll be surprised how awful it tastes when you add anything to sweeten your drinks or food. Number three, avoid soda, pops, or any kind of carbonated drinks. Replace by water, homemade teas, freshly squeezed citrus juice like oranges, lemons, or limes. Or berries. Berry smoothies are excellent, like strawberries, blackberry, raspberry, and blueberries. Number four, avoid processed foods and replace by fresh, raw vegetables and fruits. Replace processed meats by buying raw meat, poultry, or fish, and you cook yourself at home. Then, it's very different from boxed meat or fish. I find that very few people understand what processed food is. Just look at the packaged food that you have in front of you. Is it in the original state that you would find in nature? So if the food that you have has been cooked, canned, frozen, packaged, or changed with fortifying substances or preservatives, then it is processed food. Even the healthiest ingredient can be processed, and then you lose all the benefits. For example, fish. Fish is very healthy. We'll talk about this later. But if you buy a box where the fish has been prepared in a factory, fried in unhealthy oil, and added preservatives to last longer in the shelves, then it is processed fish. Number five, avoid unhealthy fats like trans fats or hydrogenated oils. Just read the labels, and you'll find these unhealthy fats in a lot of ingredients, including margarine, shortening, packaged meats, hot dogs, cookies, muffins, cupcakes, frozen pizza, microwave popcorn, and many more. Replace by healthy fats like extra virgin olive oil, canola oil, and nuts like walnuts and almonds. Check my other video about omega-3 fatty acids that I made. Well, and if you like this video so far, give a thumbs up here. Let's continue. Number six, reduce red meat. There is no need to eliminate all red meat from your diet if you want to follow an anti-inflammatory diet. Watch my other video about vitamin B12 to hear more about the deficiency of this vitamin, especially in people who restrict red meats from their diet. But it is good to limit the amount of red meat, maybe to once or twice, two meals or one per week. And replace red meat by beans, lentils, chickpeas, whole grains like kernels, quinoa, burgo, brown rice, or oatmeal. Also, green leaf vegetables like spinach, kale, and broccoli are highly recommended. Number seven, limit the amount of alcohol. There is no need to eliminate alcohol completely, but it is important to reduce the amount for a number of reasons. First, to avoid intoxication, also to avoid alcohol use disorder, and also obesity, as alcohol contains a lot of calories. And replace sweetened cocktails, beers, and spirits by red wine. One glass of red wine a day is safe, and it's rich in antioxidants. Number eight, limit the amount of coffee. There is no need to eliminate coffee, as there are some benefits, but drinking too much is not healthy. Also, you may be adding too much cream, milk, sugars, or sweeteners to your diet because of coffee. Replace coffee by green tea, for example. Green tea contains antioxidants and many healthy compounds. Number nine, avoid packaged snacks, especially when you are in a rush, hungry, and tired. You know, when you get home after a long day, when you want to grab a quick bite, sit and relax for a while, that is the dangerous hour. Have some containers with healthy snacks ready to grab. Keep an individual portion of nuts or fruits. Keep the leafy greens in your fridge, clean and ready to eat. Toss some olive oil and vinegar and eat a big salad. Leafy greens like spinach, kale, and collards are excellent anti-inflammatory ingredients, and you may use it and abuse them. Toss them in smoothies, meat or bean dishes, and you will have a lot of nutritional meals. The anti-inflammatory diet is a healthy diet. So even people who do not have chronic inflammation or chronic pain, they may benefit from adopting this diet. In order to stick to a diet, this diet for example, I recommend the P.S.C.E. approach. P is for plan. Plan your meals before you go to the grocery store, including the recipes and ingredients. Make a list of what you need to buy. S is for shopping. Only buy the ingredients in your list. Well, of course, if you see a similar ingredient that is on sale or in season and you can easily replace that in your meal plan, then go for it. But avoid the aisles of processed foods, sweets, artificial drinks, or canned foods. Spend more time in the vegetables and fruit sections. Explore and be adventurous. C is for cook. Try to cook all your meals at home. Limit the amount of takeouts and restaurants to very special occasions like birthdays or anniversaries. Invest in a nice pan set, maybe a slow cooker, a good blender, measurement tools, and kitchen utensils. If finding time to cook is a problem, then try to cook large batches for the whole week and freeze. And E is for eating mindfully. Take time to enjoy the meal, eat mindfully, observing the aroma, the colors, the texture, and taste. Eat slowly, and if possible, make it an occasion to socialize with family, neighbors, or friends. At my home, this is how I practice P.S.C.E. I kind of memorize almost all recipes that I make regularly, so I don't need to make a list anymore. Only when I want to try a new recipe, then I bring the list of ingredients with me to the grocery shop. I shop only once a week. I avoid going to the grocery store more often because I know I always end up buying some unhealthy stuff that I see and I can't resist. Then I cook dinner every evening. I always calculate 8 portions. That is because we are a family of 4 and we always eat the leftovers the next day at lunch. And if there are more than 8 portions, then I freeze them in single portions for an emergency day that I am super busy or lazy. I also prepare a healthy breakfast every morning. We eat dinner most of the days together as a family. Lunch is not always the case, as each one of us, we are usually working or in school, but we always bring our lunch boxes to school or work to warm and eat there. Remember, we are what we eat. So watch my next video here. I like to talk about vitamins, nutrients, and diet a lot in my channel. This is a topic that I think extremely important, and not a lot of doctors reinforce this to their patients. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Goodbye!